Ethiopia's Emperor Menelik II was the first African to drive a car in 1907, reigning from 1889 to his death in 1913. Emperor Menelik II was known for his territorial expansion and creation of modern Ethiopia. Emperor Menelik II was the Emperor of Ethiopia from 1889 to his death in 1913 and King of Shuwa from 1866 to 1889. At the height of his internal power and external prestige, the process of territorial expansion and creation of the modern empire state was completed by 1889. He is widely honored by many Ethiopians and commemorated during the celebration of the Battle of Adwa, which is celebrated on March 1 or 2 across Ethiopia and in the diaspora. Many Pan-Africans regard him as an advocate for African independence against European powers during the scramble for Africa. Emperor Menelik II reigned from 10 March 1889, 12 December 1813. Had his coronation on 3 November 1889 after his predecessor Johannes V. Emperor Menelik II was born on 17 August 1844 at Angolala, North Shua, Ethiopian Empire. Emperor Menelik II died on 12 December 1913 at the aged of 69 at Addis Ababa, Ethiopian Empire, and buried at Betale Mariam Monastery, now Sel Bet Kidane Maharet Church, Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. His wife's name was Tato Betul and his children were Zutatui, Shoaragad Wosan Segd. Emperor Menelik II named his house, House of Solomon. Emperor Menelik's father was Haile Melekot, the king of Shua, and his mother was Waizero Ahigeahu. As per religion, Emperor Menelik was an Ethiopian Orthodox. The Ethiopian Empire was transformed under Emperor Menelik II. The major signposts of modernization, with the help of key ministerial advisors, such as Gaberhe Wabikaden, were put in place. Externally, Menelik led Ethiopian troops against Italian invaders in the First Italo-Ethiopian War, following a decisive victory at the Battle of Adwa. Recognition of Ethiopia's independence by external powers was expressed in terms of diplomatic representation at his court and delineation of Ethiopia's boundaries with the adjacent colonies. Menelik expanded his kingdom to the south and east, into Kaffa, Saitama, Wolaita and other kingdoms. He is widely called Emeye Menelik in Ethiopia. Later in his reign, Menelik established the first cabinet of ministers to help in the administration of the empire, appointing trusted and widely respected nobles and retainers to the first ministries. These ministers would remain in place long after his death, serving in their posts through the brief reign of Ieyasu and into the reign of Empress Zutatu. They also played a key role in deposing Ieyasu.